Welcome viewers, this is Teacher Nixon as usual. Today I want us to learn something on indices and logarithm, but more specifically I will be dealing with indices. At a later date I will be talking also about logarithms. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you all. I want to believe that you are going to learn one or two things that maybe you never knew, or maybe you know but you didn't get them better. So welcome you all. I hope you are going to enjoy. I want to start first of all by defining what is an index or what is indices. So the power to which a number is raised, we refer to it as index. Index is singular, but if there are many, we refer to them as indices. And I want to discuss various concepts. More specifically, at the end of this lesson, I expect you as a learner, you are going to know the three laws of indices. Number two, I expect you to be able to prove that any number raised to power 0 equals to 1. And lastly, I expect you to apply the various concept learned, especially the three laws of indices, to solve various numerical values involving them. So I want to start by stating the first law of indices, and that is the addition law. If we take two numbers, say a power n and another number a power m, and I am multiplying these numbers, and these numbers again have a common base, you can see a and you can see the other one is also a, the powers may be the same or may be different, then the addition law tells us that when multiplying such numbers, then it is the same as taking the number then raising it to the sum of the two powers. This is the addition law. E power n, you multiply it with e power m equals to a n plus m. The other law that I want us to look at is the subtraction law. Subtraction law. Again, we are going to use the same numbers, but in this case, we are going to be dividing. So if I divide a power n divided with a power m, then the subtraction law tells us that when dividing, we are supposed to subtract the powers. That is a n minus m. A power n divided by a power m equals to a raised to power n minus m. The other law that we are going to look at, the last law, is the multiplication law. Multiplication law. Multiplication law is also referred to as the product law. And this law tells us that if you have a number, for example, a raised to power n, and this number is raised to another power, for example, m, then the answer is supposed to be a raised to power the product of the two powers. That is a power n raised to power m equals to a power n m, where n m is the product of the two powers. These are the three laws of indices. And I want to repeat for emphasis, the addition law tells us that a power n multiplied by a power m equals to a raised to power n plus m. The subtraction law, which is the second law, tells us that a power n divided by a power m equals to a power n minus m. And lastly, product law tells us that a power n raised to power m equals to a power n m. The other concept that I want us to learn is the is that given law that tells us that any given number raised to power 0 equals to 1. Equals to 1. What do I mean? Any number, for example, let's say a raised to power 0 equals to 1. Why does that happen? So let's have our proof. And for us to get this correctly, we are going to apply the second law that we have just learned, that is the subtraction law of indices. And the numbers that we are going to use will now be having similar powers, and still the basis is going to be the same. For example, take a number like a raised to power n, and this number is being divided with itself, that is a raised to power n. If we use the log division, this means that we can have a raised to power n divided by a power n, a power n, and we can cancel the common terms. And because these are the same, if we cancel, then it gives us 1. Now, suppose we apply the subtraction law of indices. By applying the subtraction law of indices, we know that we are supposed to subtract the powers. So, I want us now to apply the law. So, by applying subtraction law, then we have a power n divided by a power n equals to a n minus 1, n minus n, sorry, and this one will be equals to a power 0. But we had already gotten that when you divide this using long division, this one gives us to 1. So this one tells us that, or therefore, a power 0, which we have gotten here by applying the laws of indices, equals the answer that we have gotten here using the long division method, which is equals to 1. And that's how we say that any number raised to power 0 equals at 1. The other thing that I want us to learn is now the application of this concept that we have just learned in solving various numerical problems involving indices. And I want to give you an example. Suppose you are given a simple question like this. Solve for the value of x given that. Solve for x given that 7 raised to power 5 raised to power x equals 2. 7 power 4 raised to power x divided by 7 power 2. How do we solve this type of a question? So, and our solution, if you look at the first value here, it is going to be applying the third law that we have learned, that is the multiplication law. Still, this one happens to the first number on the right hand side, and again on the right hand side we are going to be applying the subtraction law. So let's apply the laws that we have learned so that we can remove the bracket. So the first one, by applying the product law, will have 7 power 5x, power 5x, which will now be equals to, we apply the multiplication law still on this, so that we have 7 power 4x divided by 7 power 2. That is the first method. Then the next step, we are supposed to apply the subtraction law, because here we are dividing and we can see that the bases are the same. So we'll have this one being equals to 7 power 4x minus 2. So therefore, we'll be having now 7 power 5x being equals to 7 power 4x minus 2. Now, to move or to get the value of x, we are going to equate the powers, because the bases of the numbers on the left hand side and on the right hand side are the same. You can see we have 7 power 5x and the other one equals 7 power 4x minus 2. Now, the bases here are the same, and if the bases are the same, it also means that these given powers are the same, since these two values are equal. We have this given equal sign. So what we do, we equate the powers so that we can get the value of x. So the next step means that 5x equals to 4x minus 2. 4x minus 2. So we can now bring the like terms. So the terms that we have on the right hand side, we can bring them to the left hand side, and I can see 4x here. So I can bring 4x to the left hand side, and I will have 5x minus 4x, because when 4x is taken on the left hand side, it is positive, so it becomes negative, now equals to negative 2. And when you subtract 5x minus 4x, you get x, which is equal to negative 2. Therefore, we get the value of x as negative 2. I want to believe it is clear, and we have been able to see how we can apply various laws of indices so that we can solve various numerical problems. I want to leave you with an assignment so that you can try and practice to see whether you have gotten all the concepts that are required. So for x,